Arizona. A land as immense as it is diverse. No city in the state captures the full range of Arizona and its people better than Tucson. Now there's a unique opportunity to join the Tucson of the future with this 2 million square foot complex on 350 acres adjacent to the city limits. It's an entirely self-contained, state-of-the-art facility, a plant built by IBM.
The Tech Park, technology's best address. Few places have impacted Tucson the way the Tech Park has. This contribution wouldn't have been nearly as strong if it wasn't for one man in particular.
The university has a very positive attitude towards economic development, and we are partners with the community in trying to make this community grow economically in a positive way that benefits the entire community and respects quality of life.
Bruce has been a part of the Tech Park ever since the beginning of the university's involvement. He also played a pivotal role in buying the site from IBM in 1994.
This is KGUN 9 News at 5.
When IBM reduced its workforce in Tucson in the late 80s, it left behind a very quiet business park. But ever since the University of Arizona moved into the park in January of 1995, things have been picking up. Manuel De La Rosa has more on the changes.
Besides Microsoft, Hughes, Arizona International University, and Moltec also called this business park home. Its relationships with big-name high-tech companies is helped by the University of Arizona.
Well, one, we have a wonderful facility, and secondly, there's an opportunity to have a direct relationship with the science and engineering enterprises at the university, and that's proven to be very important for many of the companies that have come into the park.
It could be a while before the business park is 100% full. Once that is done, it could be home to as many as 30 companies with a workforce of about 13,000 employees.
After only a year, it was clear the Tech Park was already exceeding expectations.
This is Eyewitness News at Noon.
A milestone of sorts for the University of Arizona Science and Technology Park. It added a ninth company today, and that means 90% of the park space is now leased.
Next month, CITCO will open at the U of A Science and Technology Park. It'll work with national and international pharmaceutical companies. And within a year, it hopes to hire 40 scientists. U of A economic developer Bruce Wright believes that'll be good for the community.
Well, this company will be hiring a lot of PhDs and master level employees. They'll be well paid, high paid employees. But more importantly, what grows out of their work are new products. And those new products can be developed and manufactured and distributed here in Tucson.
The park was booming, and thus began the foundation of technology's best address.
The mission of the Science and Technology Park is clear. It's a place where discovery begins, where university faculty and company researchers can create new ideas and new products. The park's a very special place. It's a place where companies, large and small, can grow, prosper, and compete. It's a place where their employees can work in exciting, challenging, and nurturing environment. It's a place that really sparks innovation and creativity.
There's no doubt in my mind that this Science and Technology Park will be a shaping influence in the century that lies ahead for the University of Arizona.
The University of Arizona Science and Technology Park. Imagine where it can take us. Imagine where it can take you.
A new battle for the University of Arizona over science and technology.
Once again, the U of A Science and Technology Park is fighting for its life.
The complex has been embroiled in controversy ever since the university took over the facility from IBM 4 years ago.
What's happening out there is under fire at the state legislature.
We have many private developers that are out there leasing office space, and there's no need for the universities to be in competition with them.
Bruce Wright insists the research park is doing everything it promised to do. Now he and other university officials head to Phoenix next week to try to convince state legislators.
So some political and legal wrangling ahead, Sandy. Thanks.
With the future of the park hanging in the balance, Bruce was determined to bring his vision to fruition by recruiting businesses and ensuring the park's success.
On News 13.
The U of A's Science and Technology Park has proved the naysayers wrong. In fact, it's doing so well, it needs more space.
After adding several new companies and reaching maximum capacity, the park had officially cemented its place in the community.
Most folks around here thought this was a white elephant that the university had foolishly taken responsibility for. That's vision. Vision does require risk.
This park has always been about big dreams and big ideas. Nobody thought we'd fill this million square feet of empty space in 3.5 or 4 years, and we did it.
From there, the park would enter its Renaissance phase, or Wrightissance phase. In 2003, Bruce helped expand the park by creating an international economic partnership with its sister state of Sonora.
Arizona and Sonora, sharing a vision of the future.
Good evening. It might be a Southside project, but the economic impact will be felt throughout the city.
Tonight, City Council approved a project like no other seen here in Tucson.
This is huge. It's the, without a doubt, it's the largest infill project in the city's history. It probably will never be surpassed by anything.
In 2005, the park swapped land from their original Rita Road location in exchange for land at the bridges. This allowed for there to be new collaborative spaces and university businesses closer to campus. 3 years later, the solar zone powered on, creating one of the nation's largest solar testing and demonstration sites. Throughout the park's history and all his individual achievements, Bruce always seemed to have one central motivation in mind.
We are partners with the community in trying to make this community grow.
It could dramatically change the whole character of the community. The park is really part of the fabric of this community.
That would lead to employment and more economic wealth for the community.
Our programs, our resources, and extend them out in the community.
Whether it was inspiring children to pursue a future in science.
You couldn't get any better detail actually seeing it in the workplace and anything. So, yeah, it's kind of a big part in deciding what I want to do.
Providing local startups with a means to grow their business.
If it wasn't for the park, there would be no integrated biomolecule in existence.
Or bringing thousands of high-quality jobs to Tucson, Bruce's contribution to his community cannot be understated.
Here we go.
Upon receiving the award for Tucson's Man of the Year, Bruce himself explains what exactly community means to him.
I call myself a communitarian. I have this philosophy that you need to celebrate and encourage the individual, but you also have to balance that with the needs of the community. And I think the family and community are the basic building blocks of who we are and what we're about. I had the great fortune to be chief of staff to Congressman Morris Udall, and I learned a lot from him about worldview and ideology. And he said the greatest calling in life was to do something for somebody else and to leave your community better than it was when you got there.